Hey guys, welcome to Field Notes. So while we're out today in this lovely fall weather, and as we have just filmed a video I'm very excited about, I thought I would talk about something that I started thinking about while I was researching for the Tick to Lick video, so the fossil record video that came out a while ago. I'll link it somewhere. So I live in Northern Illinois, as we probably all know. I have been to the Field Museum many, many times growing up. And in the Field Museum is one of Neil Shubin's specimens that he found of Tick to Lick. So as I've been to the museum and as I've grown up in this area, and since I understood his story, since it was discovered, basically, it has been kind of ingrained in my head. Now this is a good thing and a bad thing, because it means that I didn't question it a lot because I've heard it so many times. However, as I started researching it more, the more I found out that there actually is a decent amount of controversy surrounding Tick to Lick. Honestly, the controversy around Tick to Lick could be a video in of itself, so I don't want to spend a lot of time talking about it here. Instead, what I wanted to talk about was scientific biases. Now, as scientists, we try to eliminate our biases, and for the most part, we do a pretty good job, but everybody has biases. And I think that's a really important thing to not only recognize in ourselves, but also in the people that we listen to. So our lecturers, the scientists we see in museums, the people on YouTube. I don't want everyone to follow everything that somebody says. I want you to question it, and maybe you're just not being given enough information on a topic, and you should feel free to research it yourself and ask all of the questions. I think this is really important in not only being a citizen scientist, but also just being a science literate person, is to know that you can question what somebody is saying. I'm not saying to try and reinvent the wheel, but know that you should be able and should feel comfortable with questioning somebody who is making statements. People are not infallible, and the people that we have put trust into to educate us are also not infallible. You may have heard of the term of pet theory, and this is a term the scientists have come up with to express an idea that somebody has gotten really attached to one idea. Maybe it fits in with their research better, maybe it's a bigger opportunity to get bigger grants. In any case, they particularly like this one outcome, and as unbiased as somebody may be trying to be, subconsciously, you might really be rooting for that and making connections that aren't there. And that's what we call a pet theory. It's become kind of your pet. This is obviously not something that scientists like. We don't like the idea that we are grasping one idea more than others. That kind of eliminates the whole unbiased approach that science is supposed to have. But it does happen, and it probably happens more often than we are comfortable thinking in varying degrees. I say all this because there is quite a bit of controversy over whether Tick to Lick is really a missing link. Are we putting characteristics onto a fish that aren't really there? Are we trying to make something out of his physiology that wouldn't have been possible, but we really want to find it, so we really are going to see it? Now, it is pretty widely accepted that he is a convergence on these two points of evolution, but this is kind of the beauty of science. Other people can look at your research and go, hang on a minute. Are we really exploring all the possibilities? Basically, just question everything. Don't take what somebody is saying for granted. I know it's a harder thing to do, especially if you're connected to a certain story or a certain person that is telling the story, but it's really important. But that doesn't really stop at science. It's a life skill that everybody should kind of get used to exercising. So what do you guys think? Have you seen this sort of like pet theory play out in your colleges or with a certain famous scientist? Have you guys experienced how like frustrating it can be when somebody just brushes off your question? Remember that if it can't withstand questioning, it's probably not a great idea. So I hope you guys enjoyed our lovely outdoor vista this afternoon. Remember, if you like these videos, press like, subscribe if you want to see more of them, and I will talk to you all very soon with another video. Bye.
It's reaffirmed for us. God, I should go exercise more. Jesus Christ.